Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel where I help creators and entrepreneurs grow their businesses through social media. In this video, I'm going to be talking about which kind of posts perform best on Instagram and what you can do to try and set up your content in a way that will bring you the best results. In my social media career, I built numerous accounts to thousands and thousands of followers, and I've also grown my own account to almost 20k in less than a year. So I feel like I have a good idea on what works well and what kind of posts tend to flop. So if you have a business or you're a creator or an influencer and you care about not just growing your following on Instagram, but also reach more people, then it's important to know which kind of posts perform best and which kind of posts the Instagram algorithm likes, because you want to make the most out of your efforts. So I'm not talking about more likes, comments, and followers, but also reach, which is way more important. You want your post to reach as many people as possible so they can see your message. All right, so first I'm going to share which kind of posts perform best, and after that I'm going to tell you what you can do to apply that to your profile. All right, so let's jump right in. But first, make sure to subscribe and tap that bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video. All right, so the first type of posts that perform well are the posts that people spend a lot of time on. Okay, so there's a thing called dwell time on Instagram. Most people measure success by likes and comments, but there's also a third metric that also impacts the algorithm, and that is dwell time. So dwell time is basically how long a user looks at a post, and the Instagram algorithm takes this information into account when assessing whether it wants to push it to more people or not. So of course, the longer people look at your post, the better. First of all, it shows the algorithm that the content is interesting, and second of all, it keeps the people on the platform longer. Think about it. Instagram wants people to stay on the platform for as long as possible. So if you can't help them do that, rather than just your followers scrolling through your posts, that's definitely a plus, and Instagram will reward you by showing the post to more people, which means more reach for you, and that is the goal. So what kind of posts increase dwell time? So one of my favorite ones is carousels. You can really pack a lot of value in carousel posts, and since you can add up to 10 slides, you can literally 10x the time that someone spends on your posts. If the slides are value-packed and will make the reader actually stop at each slide and read it, the dwell time will be even longer. So the next type of content that will make people spend more time on your profile is video. You can add up to 1 minute long video to your feed, which definitely has the potential to make a person spend a lot of time watching your post. But you gotta grab and keep their attention for as long as possible. Make sure the beginning of the video draws them in, and also cut out all of the fluff, because people's attention spans are getting shorter and shorter, so there is no room for long intros or other boring moments. So while videos tend to get less likes than the photos, don't worry about that, because the most important metrics for videos are actually views and the watch time. So how long they watch it. So I wouldn't suggest you compare video engagement metrics to photos. All right, so the next thing that would increase your dwell time are long captions. Try and engage people through writing stories. Some other tips for writing a compelling long captions are to start off by announcing something to grab the attention. So you can either post a question or setting a scene. After that, answer that question and explain the benefits to the reader. End the caption with a call to action. So ask your followers to either comment, save, or forward your post to a friend that might be interested in the same content. The call to action will also boost your engagement, which brings me to my next type of post that will perform well, and that is the post that will engage your audience. All right, so you've heard me talking about how to increase engagement a million times before. But in this video, I want to tell you a little bit about my experience in being in social media for years. So no matter what niche you're in, I've noticed that selfies perform amazing because they establish that instant connection with your followers. Also, quotes are really popular. What's funny is that in my more than 300 posts I've posted on my account, which I feel like each and every one of these posts holds a lot of value, my top two performing posts are actually quotes. Also, posts that stand out visually work way better. You can achieve that by adding, for example, a pop of color. Or another thing is that if your post contains a lot of text, make sure it's readable and that it's big enough to read from the Explore page. Let me show you. So if you go to the Explore page, you'll see that some posts just really pop. Like this one, for example. But with this one, I can't really see what it says, so I'm most likely not going to click on it. Also, you want people to share and save your posts, so you can remind them to do that in the caption. I've noticed that posts that are value-packed and contain information that will be useful at a later time get most saves, which makes a lot of sense. My most saved post, for example, is where I list 30 social media courses, and the second one is 40 free stock sites. So you can definitely predict which posts are going to get more saves than the others. All right, so another way you can increase the chance of your content performing well is using the new features, and let me explain why. First of all, we don't know if Instagram's algorithm actually pushes new features more, but even if they don't, it usually takes some time for people to start using the new features, so you'll have a huge advantage in that it's not saturated yet and your piece of content will stand out and people will be more likely to check it out. So about a year ago, when I started using carousels, not many people were using them. And I really noticed a huge difference in reach when I posted a carousel in comparison to the average post, which really helped me with the growth of my account. So now everyone and their mama is doing carousels, especially in the informational space, so they don't really stand out as much anymore, but I feel like they still perform better than your average post. Also, take Instagram Lives, for example. Instagram actually sends all of your followers notifications when you go live, which is a huge bonus and gets you way more exposure than if they didn't send the notification. So I'm pretty sure if everyone was doing lives, or when everyone starts doing lives, they will stop sending the notifications and people will be less likely to watch your live. All right, so what can you do with all this information that will help your growth? First of all, check your insights and see which posts got the most likes, shares, saves, and reach. And then just try and figure out what was it about those posts that worked so well. Is it the topic, or is it the call to action, or maybe it's just the design? So when you figure that out, try and replicate it in your future posts. Another thing I would do is I would go to other people in your niche and scroll to their posts to see which ones are more successful than the others. What you can also do is go to the Explore page and deconstruct the posts you see there. Explore page is full of posts that perform amazing, and that's why they got to Explore page in the first place. So observe what type of content appears on the Explore feed and try and figure out why. With time, you'll start figuring out which posts perform best and things will get way easier. But it's also really important that you experiment. So here's a funny story. My top performing post of all times, which is actually just a little quote, I had it saved on my phone for a really long time and I didn't even want to post it because I felt like it doesn't hold much value. So one time I was in a time crunch and I decided to post it anyway and it went viral. So definitely experiment with different topics and types of content and don't worry if some of them flop completely. It's just a part of the process and it's the only way to figure out what works well. All right, guys, I hope I gave you some amazing tips that will help you with creating content for your account. Thanks so much for watching and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next one. Bye. Ryan Little.